This is when Patricia Douglas sued the town of Westerly. Okay? And in it, she claims plaintiff is a member of the town council of the town of Westerly. She was first elected to that position in 1986. Plaintiff's term as a town councilor will come to an end in November 2000. The time of her retirement, plaintiff will have served 14 years. At the time of her retirement, plaintiff will be 62 years old, her date of birth, blah, blah, blah. Now, Westerly Code Section 2-143 provides that any person serving 10 years on the council, attaining the age of 60, upon retirement from the council and not being otherwise regularly employed by the town, shall be entitled to receive a service retirement allowance of 50% of the salary received. Now, it goes on, but it's not the whole story. Unless you were on the town council in the state of Rhode Island, 1973 in May, you're not entitled to a retirement. It was that simple. I'm gonna get to that in a second. But anyway, this is outside that. Other than her position as town councilor, plaintiff is not employed by the town. After November 13th, 2000, plaintiff will not be regularly employed by the town. So, a consent judgment that was filed on October 27th, 2000, and within a few days, you had a consent judgment. Consent judgment says, upon her retirement from Westerly Town Council, effective November 14th, 2000, and so long as she is not then otherwise regularly employed by the town of Westerly, plaintiff Patricia Douglas is entitled to service allowance pursuant to Westerly Code 2-143 in the amount of $2,800 annually. Westerly Code 2-143. And this is what really ticked me off, because I went looking for the ordinance on your pension. And it's in there, it's still in there. But you know it's not good. You know it's not good. You have to be there on March 17th, 1973. So why is it still an ordinance if you know you cannot buy into the Rhode Island Municipal Employees Retirement Account?
It's not good because you say it's not good?
No, you know it's not good because you tried to get in, and you've been told that you can't get in unless you're, and I have the letter you got from the retirement board.
Madam Chair, just let him speak, please.
I will. I'll let him finish.
Don't interrupt him. I want him to speak. Continue.
Oh, I asked a question on
employment
system of Rhode Island, March 17th, 2000. It is our opinion that Ms. Douglas would not fall under the provisions of Rhode Island General Law 4521.17.1, as she is not a member of the council when the act was passed in May of 1973. I was giving you a chance to appeal that. You didn't appeal it. You passed a resolution to get around it. I'm just asking, why is the ordinance still there?
Continue.
Mr. Lombardo, I would like you to continue, and then we will answer. Continue, please.
Okay.
I've asked you to continue, Mr. Lombardo.
Thank you. So.
Then we will answer your questions.
Okay. So now Ms. Douglas is back on the town council and is again regularly employed by the town. But she gets two checks. One for her service on town council and one on the pension, even though it clearly states in the consent order that she only gets as long as she's not regularly employed. And I think that, I know you can argue this and that, you can argue around it, but the fact of the matter is it's an agreement. Now, I want to read something else. Clearly states in the law that you have to be on the town council in May of 1973. You can't get around that. But I want to read from this was May 12th, 1980. The guy who introduced the Rhode Island pension was a gentleman by the name of Antonio Trovato, and he took pains to put this into the record. And I want to read it, because I don't know where he is, but I think it's important.
He's in St. Sebastian. He's deceased.
Okay. So I will read his words. I would like to speak to clarify my position on this issue. I have learned that the ordinance before us only provides what other communities already have based on state enabling legislation. The ordinance before us allows us to enter the system at no cost to the town. The counselor will pay his or her actual share as established by the state of Rhode Island. No counselor who has served his or her community for an extended period of time should be deprived of what others in our state already have and is given in appreciation as tokenism for the service they have performed. I, as a town counselor, future counselor, and someday former town counselor and state senator, will speak out vehemently in the future if any council tampers with our legislative intent. I repeat, this pension must be at no cost to the town and shall come out of the counselor's salary received by the town and should be considered part of the salary. Mr. President, if you may, I request that this statement be made a part of the official minutes of this town for all future councils to see and read. But it does cost the council, it does cost the town money for your pensions. Now, the last thing I'm going to get to is the way I was able to figure this out was reading through the minutes. And on one of the minutes, late at night, you passed the resolution to give yourselves a pension as a resolution. And then about three resolutions down, you agreed to pay Lauren Jones the legal fees. And you do it under the indemnity of public officials and employees. And there's just no way that's an indemnity. When somebody sues the town, you don't indemnify the plaintiff. It's right here in the law. It's only for defense. But you do whatever you want. And I'm not individually, I don't know who was there, and I don't really care. But you do willy-nilly whatever you want. And I don't understand how you think that the people down there are going to respect you when you make up your own laws. There's no provision for a pension in the charter. Read it. It's salaries. Council may determine the annual salaries by ordinance. You have a pension by resolution. I don't think you have the guts to put it in an ordinance. Put it in an ordinance. It says here in the charter you have to put it in an ordinance. There's no ordinance for salaries. There was a temporary ordinance. The council president shall receive not more than $600 annually, and the other councilman shall receive not more than $400 annually until such amount is changed by the council in accordance with the provisions of this chapter, which say you have to do it by ordinance. The only ordinance you have in there about pensions is Rhode Island, and I don't see anything about salaries at all. But the Rhode Island pension you have a reference to when you know, hell will freeze over before you get a pension from the Rhode Island Municipal Employees Union for a town council. So it's disingenuous to say that's my opinion. Because if you want to argue it factually, then we can argue it. But the fact of the matter is, you're giving yourself pensions through resolutions. And so, I find that offensive. I don't care how much you pay yourselves. I don't think you get paid enough. I think you do a hell of a lot of work for very little money. Most people think you're crazy for doing it. But could you do things in the light of day, not resolutions? Follow your charter. I don't like that. I went to school at State Street, and there was Agnes King was there, Florence Kennedy, Ella Solovitzik, and Councilman Carson. And they were strict. And they raised a whole generation of kids that I still in contact with some of them, good people, because they were not just educating us, but they were teaching us how to be citizens. They were strict, but they were fair. And there was a line that they drew. And on one side of that line was right, and one side was wrong. And you didn't have any question about what side you're on. Now, I know things get a little complicated when you get out of elementary school, but still, if you want a pension, pass an ordinance and give yourself a pension. If you want a salary, pass it. But 10:47 at night or later, you're passing a resolution to give yourself a pension. No debate, nothing. I find that offensive. And that's all all the documents for the municipal court, this matter with the pensions, and also I have another one on this personal property tax, which I'm gonna come back and talk about the personal property tax in Westerly. That's also not being done legally. If you wanna have a law, you gotta follow the law. Not the way you wanna do it, but the way the law says. But those are all on my website, lombardolegal.com, resources, and you'll find them all under all the documents pertaining to these, and you can follow them. But I would like to hear, and I can sit down, how you just vote yourself a pension, or how you get around the consent order. I'd like to hear that.